I'd like to start both of you ladies off with the classic question. Who are you wearing?
I'm wearing a vintage 60s gown.
Azazi, the 2020 collection color vintage mauve.
I am wearing David's bridal.
Squeezed into my prom dress.
Let me just give you a full view. This dress I was going to wear to prom.
I too am squeezed into ye olde prom dress. And so how many chances thus far have you had to wear the wedding gown?
This is my third.
Wearing a dress I got on final sale at Macy's for $20.
I'm wearing, what am I wearing? A dress shirt?
I'm wearing a lovely floral romper.
From Forever 21.
I've got the athletic chic look going on right here.
Sorry, that's it. I know I get the boot for today.
I toot it. You're giving me like 7th grade English teacher vibes.
And here's what I'm drinking.
Will you and Juan be icing each other tonight?
So I'm wearing the 2009 Versace SeaWorld collection.
Vintage.
It's waterproof. It's very easy. Made from real sharks. Do we boot it? I toot it. I, for one, toot this look.
You toot it?
I'm going to give that a hard toot.
Toot and boot. I toot Caitlyn tonight.
I am also going to toot Caitlyn for 2000s rom-com vibes. I mean, some people in this chat are simp for just Jeff Bezos. I am a simp for a jumpsuit, so that's an easy toot for me.
No, actually, I would like to take back my toot and give her more than a toot. I'd like to give her a shoot.
Because I am also wearing a jumpsuit.
I also went for a jumpsuit.
Jumpsuit!
What is this toot thing? And did I miss? Is this a thing?
So I'm going to have to give that a toot.
Big toot for me.
Thank you so much.
I love the sheer little jacket moment that we're having right now. There, trend alert, everybody.
Biggest trend of the night were jumpsuits, bridesmaids of year past, and hoops, of course.
This was voted for by a few people. And if you know Claire and Elizabeth, you know they're tight, just like Sid and I were from day one. These ladies hit it off. They're the exact opposite in the right way of each other. And they just complement each other in the perfect way. So Claire, Elizabeth, we love you.
We realized we couldn't do a cutest couple because we had two couples. So we're going to duke it out and we're going to have the cute couple face off. What? The first question for the guys. What did the girls wear on your first date?
I was thinking the fox shirt, but I don't know if I'll let you throw away.
I know she had a green scarf and she was wearing a white shirt, probably a black cardigan over.
That's pretty accurate.
Okay, I'm going to give it to them both. They both got that right. Their pet name, like when they say, oh, sweetie, oh, muffin, what do they call you?
Bean.
I'd say mostly hun, but before we started dating, it was, hey, asshole.
And they both got those right. What is your partner most likely to go to jail for?
She would be like yelling at a cop and saying like, no, I wasn't speeding, or like yelling at authority.
I can't picture her in jail. Wow. Is something stupid like stealing yarn? Stealing yarn.
Michael, you're wrong. Juan got that right. Well, what is your partner's favorite pizza topping?
Mushroom, canned mushroom.
Like pineapple and olives.
Yeah.
Pineapple? Mike, you got that right. Juan, you did not.
What?
It's one topping.
What is your partner's dream job? Like, if they could do anything in the world, what would they do?
Zina would want to be a college
dream job.
Yeah,
sorry.
Not college advisor. She would want to be a college rep or like, no, oh God.
Juan, are you sure?
Want to be a college counselor. There we go.
This is gonna break up. Okay.
Well, lately you want to be a really cute history teacher, but longer than that, you've wanted to be a YouTuber and also a crochet person.
Both of you are wrong. Isabel said she wanted to be a fashion historian, and Zina said she wanted to be a chef.
Since when?
Where would your partner like to travel more than anywhere else in the world?
The Caribbean.
No.
Swear to God, if I get this wrong, I'll be mad.
Scotland.
Scotland, you said? Jill and Isabel win.
Wow.
4-3. Juan, you were so close with the Bahamas. Unfortunately, Zina said Fiji.
It's fine. We also talked about it. He doesn't pay attention. It's okay.
All right. We are going to keep moving with my favorite award of the night, the best Zoom moments. The Minute to Win It games hosted by Reva last week were absolutely hilarious. My loud, obnoxious typing and Claire and Isabel's issues with their microphone. And of course, how could we forget the icon, the legend, Brendan trying on his romper for the Grimmy All-Star Award. The male winner is going to be Zach for his riveting stories. He is a comedian of GroupMe. And if that was a platform, I think he would be famous by now. So I would just like to read this excerpt from some of my favorite moments of Zach in our group chat. Was using the office sink and a little gremlin, no more than 4 feet tall, came over and stuck their face towards the trash can right next to me and sneezed. As if they were actually trying to aim their sneeze into the trash can. Get me out of this bacterial hellhole.
I just can't believe these things actually happened. I'd actually forgotten about them and just reading them back. I'm so happy that you were able to find these.
Other GroupMe All-Star Award is Angela because Angela kept us at flying by the seat of our pants. I accidentally walked in on the science teacher during his plan exam period as he was screaming into his jacket. Happy Thursday. But then again, this is also my school where a student got in trouble for putting piss in the water fountains. And the staple quote, the principal is MIA.
You only got all of these messages in a span of like a month and a half too.
We are going to have musical stylings from Claire Nowinski as we look back on the memories and the things that we've lost this year. We asked all of you to submit your first world problems and the things that you've lost. And hopefully Claire will be able to accompany those feelings.
If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of a sea of college apps and Zoom calls, if you ever find yourself in a crumbling society, I'll be your light through it all. We find out what we're made of when we're stuck at home cause of quarantine. But you can count on me and CAC, and we'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you, OMSU, and you'll be there. Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh, ooh, yeah. We'll always have Trish, Carrie, and Meg, yeah. And Megan McComb when you need help with Excel. know you can count on me. And CAC will be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you. OMSU, and you'll be there. 'Cause that's what friends are supposed to do. Oh, yeah. Ooh.